Have a look at this. And here's a question for you. What does what you're seeing right here have to do with neutrinos? Do you know the answer? Got a guess? Write it in the comments right now, and by the end of this video, you'll know if you were right. What this is a form of a coupled pendulum. In this case, it's a three-way coupled pendulum. We have regular pendulum masses, big steel balls on the end of metal sticks. But the thing that's different is that we've coupled them together using two identical springs. This makes the motion far more interesting. Now, you might be familiar with simple harmonic oscillators. The pendulum is one, and so is a mass on the end of a spring. And they each have their own natural frequencies that they'd like to oscillate at. What we really need to do is look at things called normal modes. These are the ways that any dynamical system, any system that will wobble around its equilibrium point, likes to oscillate in a completely independent fashion. This is the first normal mode. Here's the second. And finally, the third normal mode. Excite that system in a normal mode and it will keep on doing exactly that oscillatory motion without any amplitudes changing or any weird behavior forever, assuming no energy loss through, say, friction. Just setting one pendulum into motion isn't one of the normal modes, and therefore it must be described by a superposition of the three normal modes. That means basically adding them together with certain amounts. But this is where the interesting stuff goes on, because if you add two sine waves together that have very slightly different frequencies, like we do with the normal modes, you get a phenomenon called beating. This is given by an oscillation at the average frequency of those two original sine waves, but the amplitude slowly changes over the difference in those two frequencies. So, onto neutrinos now. This is a demonstration of neutrino oscillation. Anyone get that right? In this case, each pendulum can be thought of as the three flavors of neutrinos that are created by the weak interaction. That's the electron neutrino, the muon type neutrino, and the tau neutrino. Just like with quantum mechanics, where the amplitude of the wave function tells you the probability of observing a particle at that location, in this case, the amplitude of each pendulum tells you the probability of observing that type of neutrino in an experiment. Set off an electron type neutrino, for instance, created the heart of the sun. By the time it travels to the Earth, it's not 100% probability of still being in that neutrino type. In fact, we only observe a third of the electron type neutrinos. Just like with this pendulum, the neutrino normal modes don't correspond to the neutrino flavor types. We call these neutrino normal modes, in fact, mass states. Because in free space, the natural states of particles will have defined energy and momenta as a wave-like state, then they have well-defined masses as well. This means there are three neutrino masses, which cannot be the same. It was this understanding of neutrino oscillations which won the 2015 Nobel Prize in Physics. But neutrinos are still some of the least understood particles in the universe, probably because they interact so rarely with most of the matter around us. It's still a very active area of research, all nicely summed up with some balls and some springs. Thank you so much for watching this video. Props have to go out to Geoff from the mechanical workshop at Queen Mary's School of Physics and Astronomy. He made this amazing demo for me, so thank you very much, Geoff, and thank you for watching. Do remember to like, subscribe, and watch some other more videos of my stuff. Kiss.